How are we doing, folks?
Right.
Wow. Watch this new top of IKS gear here.
What can I say?
Right, so we're in Dover at the moment. Going to be checking out World War II pillbox. This design is only in the Dover area. These were possibly among the first World War II pillboxes constructed in World War II and may predate the FW3. Design. So let's check this out, folks. So this is only in Dover area. There's quite a few of these pillboxes around. There's another one further over that way. Check that out another day. We're just doing this pillbox in this video, folks. So basically this is a fort, and they overhang the valleys of Dover. So this was like built in 1940s when the threat of invasion was among us, folks. It's a simple design. I have got a torch, folks, so this, you can see that, that's a video light that I used many moons ago. It's a Kudos Nog, I believe, folks. They're good little lights, don't last very long though. So let's check this thing out. Probably don't even need it. Oh, they're alright. There'll be a bit of dust on the lens, but this is the vision you get through the slits over Aycliffe. Amazing views, especially from the top. Good sunbathing. So yeah, you got these little holes underneath that are possibly some sort of storage for, I don't know, ammunition, folks, or something like that, maybe. I don't know whether they kitted these out in the Second World War when the invasion was on the horizon. They might have been all kitted out ready. But yeah, I'm not sure about that. The slab, you can see the grain of the wood still in the concrete there. Look, see the boards. That's mad. So this is real history as well, folks. And that's only a small thing, but this is history. A World War II pillbox. And now, well, I think sheep have been in it, cows probably. It's a nice place when it's really windy. It's nice in here. Cozy. And there's two next to the door, there's two smaller slits. What if they've been bricked up? Might have been bricked up, folks. So yeah, overlooking the Aycliffe Valley, folks. On the other side, it's over looking over Maxton and stuff like that. So it's just over the valleys, and if the German forces, I guess, come through the valleys, then they could sort of fire on them and stuff like that. But apparently these ones weren't very strong due to the design. We're talking about, say, what's the word with gunshots? Ah, oh, for God's sake. Basically where bullets sort of ricochet, that's a ricocheting and stuff like that. So it could ricochet and it could go everywhere inside there. So yeah, the designs were poor. It's possibly why it was the first ones to be built, and then they made better designs. Yeah. So yeah, 1940s, folks. We'll be going to the next ones. Future videos. Stay tuned for them, folks. Stay tuned indeed.
Right, folks.
So yes, just having a look around this pillbox, and this didn't even occur to me inside a pillbox. I just thought it might have been just mud. So we found a concrete floor, basically.
And there it is.
That is absolutely mental. God knows where all this mud and that's come from. It must be cows and sheep bringing it in.
But yeah, never even thought about that. So there's a concrete floor inside a pillbox, folks.
Might sound like I'm fascinated there, but I am. I don't think there's a lot of these type of pillboxes that I've seen that's got the floor exposed. We'll get to them, folks. We'll get to them. Quite a few to get through yet. Right, so yeah, that's basically it then, folks. Dover's pillbox. The quad pillbox. Super amazing. I read up earlier, I can't find it now, but this is around. There's possibly 9,000 examples of pillboxes still intact around. Out of like 26,000 or something like that. So a hell of a lot have been demolished and stuff like that, folks. That's sort of an average example of what we're talking here. It's not 100% accurate, but put a link below in the description to sort of pillbox stuff, folks. Yeah, that's basically it. Thanks very much for watching. Check out Instagram, Facebook and all that jazz. See you soon.